Welcome to evening prayer.
In the presence of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Blessed Trinity, we meet with gratitude in quietness and reflection as the day heads to its close. So we ask God to bless the road that we have travelled and those we have met along the way, the glances we have exchanged, and the prayers and words we've shared. For Lord, you have searched us and known us. When we sit and when we rise, you perceive our thoughts from afar and discern our going out and our lying down. You are familiar with all our ways. Before a word is on our tongue, you know it completely, Lord. You hem us in behind and before and lay your hand upon us. So be with us as we pray. Guide our thoughts and our hearts. Amen. Some reading from Ezekiel chapter 33. And verses 30 to 33. As for you, mortal, your people who talk together about you by the walls and at the doors of the houses, say to one another, each to a neighbour, come and hear what the word is that comes from the Lord. They come to you as people come, and they all sit before you as my people, and they hear your words, but they will not obey them. For flattery is on their lips, but their heart is set on their gain. To them you are like a singer of love songs, one who has a beautiful voice and plays well on an instrument. They hear what you say, but they will not do it. When this comes, and come it will, then they shall know that a prophet has been among them. In the days of the Back to Church Sunday, everyone was encouraged to invite someone to come to a service. And the important thing actually behind it wasn't necessarily that everyone would say yes, but the invitation was made. Those words ring in my ears. How will they know if no one tells them? How will they hear if no one speaks? And in a sense, as we hear those verses from Ezekiel, it's an encouragement to keep sharing whether or not people appear to be listening or interested in the message that we have to share. But to be faithful and make the invitation. The response isn't down to us. God will work that through. We just need to be open. So we continue in prayer. We ask you to be our guide, Lord of life, in each step that we take. To be our strength in each load that we bear. To be our power in climbing the mountains. Our safety in crossing rivers. Our peace in each place where we might rest. And our joy in every sunrise and sunset. So we pray for those whose spiritual journey is only just beginning. We pray for those whose journey of faith is beset by doubt and uncertainty. We pray for those whose daily journey is hindered by pain or suffering. We pray for those who spend their journey helping others, struggling along the road. Lord, bless each one for whom we pray. Let our eyes be your eyes, sharing compassion, warmth and love. Let our hands be your hands, bringing healing with their touch. Let our ears be your ears, listening where there is need. Let our words be your words, bringing comfort, joy, and peace. God of the morning, be with us when we rise. God of the noontime, be with us in our walk. God of the evening, be with us as we head to rest. So we share in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So may the blessing of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and on each one for whom we have prayed this night and forevermore. Amen.